Israel approving the entry of more aid into Gaza. It said Friday it will reopen the Erez crossing into northern Gaza and the temporary use of Ashdod port in southern Israel. The move came hours after a tense phone call between Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and U.S. President Joe Biden, who demanded concrete steps to alleviate the humanitarian crisis in the besieged enclave. The killing of 7 aid workers Monday, which triggered global outrage, sheds light on the lingering problems with aid deliveries into Gaza. United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres hopes the opening of more entry points will improve what he called a desperate situation in the Strip.
In the aftermath of this tragedy, the United Nations was also informed by the Israeli government of its intention to allow a substantial increase in humanitarian aid distributed in Gaza. I sincerely hope that these announced intentions are effectively and quickly materialized, because the situation in Gaza is absolutely desperate.
This comes ahead of a fresh round of Gaza ceasefire in Cairo happening this weekend. A U.S. official says they are working for the release of sick and elderly hostages being held by Hamas militants. The Israeli military sacks two officers and reprimanded senior commanders after an investigation into the killing of the aid workers in Gaza this week found serious errors and breaches of procedure. The military says Israeli forces mistakenly believed they were attacking Hamas gunmen when the drones hit the three vehicles of the World's Central Kitchen.
The soldiers conducted the strike without any awareness that these were in fact WCK vehicles. At the time, they were certain that they were targeting Hamas. This operational misidentification and misclassification was the result of internal failures that led to a critical information regarding the humanitarian operation to not go properly down to the chain of command.
The World Central Kitchen now demanding an independent commission to investigate the incident. The U.S. on high alert for a possible attack by Iran in response to Israel's strike on the Iranian embassy in Syria. A U.S. official said security officials are in a high state of vigilance as they expect an Iranian attack targeting Israeli or American assets in the region could happen next week. On Monday, suspected Israeli warplanes bombed Iran's embassy in Damascus, killing an Iranian military commander along with six other military officials. In the U.S., a magnitude 4.8 quake struck New York Friday morning, rattling residents in an area that rarely experiences seismic activity. The quake's epicenter was detected in Tewksbury in central New Jersey. No major damage or injuries were reported, but residents were urged to take cover during possible aftershocks. The tremor was the largest felt in the city since 2011.
This is one of the largest earthquakes on the East Coast occur in the last century. So I immediately directed my emergency management team, the second we received word of this, to start doing damage assessments, any life in danger, and finding out whether there's any bridges or tunnels that are compromised.
U.S. President Joe Biden seeking accountability for the Baltimore bridge collapse. Biden got a first-hand look Friday at efforts to clear away the rubble of the collapsed bridge as cranes, ships, and diving crews work to reopen one of the nation's main shipping lanes. Biden says his administration will not rest until the bridge is back to normal. He asserts parties responsible for the incident should help pay to repair the damage.
My administration is committed. Absolutely committed to ensuring that the parties responsible for this tragedy pay to repair the damage and be held accountable to the fullest extent the law will allow. We'll also never forget the contributions these men made to this city. We're going to keep working hard to recover each of them. And you know, my vow is that we will not rest, as Carlos said, until the cement has dried and the entirety of a new bridge,
Biden also met the families of the six people killed in the tragedy. The victims were all immigrants from Mexico and Central America who were fixing potholes on the road surface of the bridge when it collapsed. America's closely watched jobs report is out, and it's not looking good for rate cuts. The Labor Department stateside reports employers hired more workers than expected in March, with 303,000 jobs added. That's well above the anticipated 200,000. The unemployment rate, meanwhile, declined to 3.8% last month, a touch lower than February's 3.9%. This strong jobs report, while indicating a healthy economy, gives the Fed elbow room to keep rates higher for longer, casting doubts on market expectations that the Fed will cut key rates in June.